How is a society built? Where are its builders made? And who makes them? A teacher, undoubtedly. But who is a teacher? A teacher is one who alone teaches, who has something to give. For teaching is not talking. Teaching is not imparting mere doctrines. It is communicating with the soul for its enlightenment. India and its rich traditions have always focused and cared to give due importance to teachers as they make mere commoners inclined to high esteem. The nation commemorates the birth ceremony of the Honorable Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan as the National Teachers' Day on 5th of September every year. Dr. Radhakrishnan was born to Tamil parents in Madras Presidency, now Chennai. The family always had room for learning and education. His father, Sarvepalli Veeraswamy, was a learned man and worked as a revenue official in the service of a local zamindar. Dr. Radhakrishnan studied at Madras Christian College on a scholarship and by chance came to study philosophy, which became his lifelong attachment. It was at the Madras Christian College where Dr. Radhakrishnan discovered his area of interest in philosophy. He found that Indian philosophy and its culture were highly underestimated and faced unwanted and unethical criticism from the West. Disturbed by such inhuman treatment of the country's philosophy, Dr. Radhakrishnan started to find a way to defend Indian philosophy in the World Forum. Earlier, Swami Vivekananda had offered prosperous and energetic teachings on Indian philosophy and taught its values to the modern world. Inspired by the approach of Swami Vivekananda towards Indian philosophy, Dr. Radhakrishnan wrote a brilliant thesis named The Ethics of the Vedanta and its Metaphysical Presuppositions. His thesis was examined by High Priest of Philosophy, Dr. Alfred George Haug, who instead of hushing it up, openly came out and admitted that Radhakrishnan had done a brilliant piece of work. Radhakrishnan later contributed much more to Indian philosophy through his writings and lectures. He earned a reputation as a bridge builder between India and the West. In spite of all his contributions to philosophy and its values, Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan is best known as a teacher of extraordinary excellence. He was loved among his students for his love and commandment towards the subject, and also for his brilliance in the profession of teaching. Dr. Radhakrishnan was elected as the second president of independent India after Dr. Rajendra Prasad, where his statesmanship also earned a lot of respect for India outside. During this tenure, his students asked him that they wanted to celebrate his birthday. But Dr. Radhakrishnan, in his characteristic view, said, "Instead of celebrating my birthday, it would be my proud privilege if September 5th is observed as Teachers' Day." Thus, India started celebrating 5th September as Teachers' Day from 1962. Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan will always be remembered as a philosopher, a statesman, a beloved president, and an excellent teacher. He would be remembered as an epitome of an ideal teacher and a nation builder. As he himself said on one occasion, "Teachers should be the best minds of nation." Dr. A.P.J. Abdul Kalam, best known to us as the Missile Man of India, also conferred once that he would like to be remembered as a teacher above all. Even when he became President of India in 2002, he missed no opportunity to get a chance for teaching students. Administering a pledge on national development to the youth was his passion. Dr. Kalam always had room for students. He visited every possible schools, colleges, or universities to guide and offer teachings to young minds. His love for teaching was such that the dramatic life of this national hero ended while he was offering a teaching to a bunch of students at IIM Shillong. Dr. Kalam has to his contribution in making India's defense system unleashed, for which he received the Bharat Ratna in year 1997. But who can deny that this brilliant man has occupied a huge space in every student's mind through his teaching of values towards life and education. We are all proud to be his countrymen. Teachers' Day comes every year on 5th of September, but a teacher is always confined every day towards his noble profession. A teacher makes a nation, and thus a nation in turn should produce teachers as well. Today, when the world is running hay towards technology and innovation, a sheer lack of interest towards the profession of teaching can be seen in students. But what kind of technology can bring prosperity when there will be no teachers to teach to build it? India has a long tradition of making not only good students but also good teachers, devoted teachers who have shaped the society for millennia. These teachers are such visionaries who have visioned the vision for future. It is our proud privilege as well to have some good teachers who make us what we are.